I wanted to start off this video with a rant slash warning. There is no customer service whatsoever with Gamigo. I put in this ticket in October. My ticket was about the labor stipend that I bought when Tryon was the publisher of Archeage. When I logged back into my account after my absence, I saw that the 30-day labor stipend was only good for 3 days, and the vocation stipend that was supposed to also be good for 30 days was only good for 15. And seeing that there was an obvious screw-up, I put in a ticket. Well, 3 days ago, they finally get back to me after roughly about 3 months in the queue with a "sorry, we can't help you" response. Personally, I would be very careful with buying anything from Gamigo because if they're not watching the store, they're probably not watching the credit card system, and they may not be updating the database to the web store, and they probably have no system admin, just some monkey in a data center pushing the reset button every once in a while. Now, I knew this was going to be a clown show going in because this game is such a massive cash grab. It always has been and most likely always will be. There is zero in the way of customer service, and it's been nothing but problem after problem. I mean, here's some more examples. There were the larders that were disappearing after maintenance, and then the library had a lot of lag. By comparison, Archeage, which is a private server, they run things better than Gamigo does. They actually have customer service. They actually have banned botters and speed hackers. And they've never had any of these strange problems with larders vanishing or quests not being complete like they should. And I'm not going to say they were perfect 100% of the time, but it was certainly miles ahead of what Gamigo is. But then when you see the other side of the story, you at least get a better understanding of why things are the way they are. According to Glassdoor, Gamigo makes anywhere from $10 to $25 million per year. The company isn't rated well by its employees because it has low pay, no one cares if you do your job, and you might even get yelled at for doing your job too well. They work on old computers and they complain of a terrible work environment. When I got the response that I got, sure, I was angry about it, but I do understand where the employees are coming from, and I have a lot of sympathy for them. But at the same time, if a company is charging people for a product, it should work the way they say it should work. The attitude shouldn't be, "well, tough shit, we have your money." But this is how it was under Tryon, and it seems like Gamigo's doing the same thing. In my last video on Archeage Unchained, I called it a train wreck and said it was terrible, which it is, and I got some very bizarre responses. People were actually sticking up for Gamigo's incompetence, like in this comment.
"This video is trash, laughing my ass off. ArchPass is amazing and you're just bitching."
So when the ArchPass crashes systems and it doesn't complete the quests when you're done with them and it counts points in the negative numbers when you get disconnected, so it counts it backwards, that must mean it works, right? You know, I have this really weird thinking that if you pay money for a game, it should work properly. I know that's pretty wild, isn't it? The comment goes on to say,
"Also, equipment and vocation or whatever costs 5 gold to unlock, not 10 bucks.
I did point it out in the video, but okay, we could go over it anyway. So as you see here, the basic pass, it says 10 gold. That's a 10. And the Arch Pass upgrade is 1,500 credits, which you can buy for $10, so I hope that clears it up for you. And then there's this comment.
"You just need time. If you're not willing to spend time on the game, do not play it. If you hate it being grindy, it's your problem, your opinion."
But when you're faced with a quest where you have to gain 1 million XP in order to complete it, that's quite the challenge. But yet, the answer is so simple. I should have seen it before. I can just bot and kill mobs from underground. That's some legit shit, yo. I mean, the more you know, am I right?
Bruh.
And in case one account isn't grindy enough, they allow you to buy 3 of them, and you get 2 characters per account. So that's 6 characters you're expected to grind, and then transfer all of the gold over to your main character. They sort of took out the pay-to-win and kept the labor on a slow drip, and at the same time, increasing the grind because you're rotating in between three accounts. And here's how Archeage Unchained is still pay-to-win. Because you simply put into a search engine, you type in, buy gold in Archeage Unchained. You know, because no one's ever done that before. And surprise, surprise, quite a few results come up. And the person who just bought the gold from one of these sites, get this, they just paid to win. Mind blown. People knew this was coming. They saw it a mile away. The alts were a part of what ruined the economy before when people were running around with 20-something alts. This game was nicknamed Alt Age for a reason. And in Unchained, you still can't get away from it. The terms of service is a joke. If they cannot find a purchase I made in their system with a reference number that links to that purchase, how are they going to stop real money trading? And the employees don't seem like they really give a shit. They put the bare minimum effort into this game, and it definitely shows.
Bruh.